You know that feeling where it's past December 25th, but it still feels like
Christmas?
Right, and then you watch a game like that and you realize that it's just December.
Let's go!
Good, we all feel
good. Stop!
It never gets rusty!
What am I doing?
Into my kitchen! Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple, crumple, yeet!
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR. Leafs lose 4-2 against the Ottawa Senators. The Leafs never show up against the bottom teams in the league. They lost those two games to Chicago, and now they've lost to Ottawa again this season in their own building again. You know how many people texted me after this game going, why do the Leafs never show up against the Sens? Like, it's not a playoff game, boys. You're allowed to show up. Oh, I went there. Yes, I went there. Bah, humbug and all of that. Listen, I had a good Christmas. It was a lovely Christmas, but that game was just another game in December. So we're gonna do a bit of a different video format for this one. Because it's just December, we're gonna do a little airing of grievances. So we're gonna have a much longer question section. We'll start by talking about the good, and it's not gonna take long because it only lasted 20 minutes! Like, listen, the Leafs' first period was not perfect by any means. They did give up some chances, but the shots were 12-6. Tyler Bertuzzi alone should have had more goals than the Ottawa Senators. The Leafs score two goals in less than 30 seconds, and they escape with a 2-0 lead. Isn't that a good period? That feels like a good period. Matthew snipes it, but then nies it, goes just off of his pinky toe and in. But that's how you score. That's how you score. If you're Matthew Nyes, that's how you score. Auston Matthews shoots. So your job is to create chaos in front, and every now and then, you're rewarded with a bonus that goes towards your next contract where the puck just goes off you. Your foot, your elbow, maybe your bum. It goes in and it counts as yours. 23 seconds later, Morgan Riley sends it across to Tyler Bertuzzi. Bertuzzi was able to put it in. Why was he able to put it in? Because he goes to the net! And I'm watching this going, not only are the Leafs the better team, but they're scoring. It's after the Christmas break. We have to start paying attention to this. Playoff-style goals. Matthew Nyes, it's fluky. Guess what? Playoffs. Tyler Bertuzzi, go to the net. Guess where he had 10 points in 7 games while with the Bruins? In the playoffs. Don't ask how it ended. Tyler Bertuzzi could have had that thing 6-0 on his own by the end of the first. Artem Zub is the only reason it wasn't at least 4-0. And the Leafs go into intermission with a 2-0 lead. Hooray! Beginning of the second period, you're seeing some of that complacency, but they still got their foot, like, a little on the gas. They're not just rolling to a stop. But then the moment they got the lead, in the middle of the second period, 20 professional hockey players decided, you know what? I don't feel like playing professional hockey. Dude, I love William Nylander. He's had an incredible season. He's had the best season of his life. This is not a double-digit contract effort. This is an American Hockey League effort. Forget the game notes. That's Claude Giroux. What's the matter with you?
It's all right, boys. I got him. I don't got him. Ah, it's in the net. That's a shame. Hey, anyone got a pen?
That's a great player with not even a good effort. The Sens are within one. That's a shorthanded goal. A little later on, Tim Stützle gets a step on Morgan Riley. He shoots. Why not? He's stopped by Martin Jones. Now, Martin Jones does that thing that all not the greatest goalies do, where they drift a little bit. So the puck is in the slot, and it's wide open. Can I show you something that I don't know if it'll ruin your night, but I'm positive it ruined mine? Two loss at home, next generation game, whatever, at the hands of the Ottawa Senators. The 5-2 loss to the Rangers. You know, Steve, where was this for that game? Is it because this is added onto it? No, it's got nothing to do with that. Leaf fans who have been here for a long enough time, who have the scar tissues, right? Like, you cheered through 2014, like those kind of scar tissues. 2008. Some of you, underratedly bad time, the mid to late 90s. Not the too late 90s, the mid to late, the 97, these are the games that drive you nuts. This wasn't that game against the New York Rangers where you could argue they're the better team and gosh, just the puck just kept bouncing. That happens enough times you get upset about it. That didn't happen in this game. It happened in this game where the Leafs were the better team. They were the clearly better team and they got spanked and outworked the rest of the way, which is why I want to dig this little lineup before we even get to the end of the video from Sheldon Keefe. Boy, he really knows how to read a room with a quote like this. Keefe, Ottawa got better and harder as the game went on, and we didn't respond to that. You know what? This might sound like Sheldon Keefe calling out and rallying his troops if it wasn't the 90,000th time we've heard him say it about this group. You can call the personnel soft, it's a lot easier to move the coach. And also, it's framed in a way that puts it on the players, and a lot of it is on the players, but what really happened? The Leafs had a great first period, they came prepared. That's, hey, you know what? That's points for the coach and the coaching staff. What happened after the first period is the team that was getting outplayed adjusted. Man, when the Leafs are playing a team and that team adjusts, finished. Forget it. If they're not getting goaltending, which they're not, they're done. Dude, the last time Jacques Martin was the head coach of an NHL team was around this time 11 years ago! And you got outcoached by that guy? You wanna know what makes it worse? It was actually 12! Horrible, garbage, unacceptable. Now, the last goal is Batherson shooting it from... Can I just show you where he shot it from? No! No! Absolutely not! No! 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 I don't want to just yell all of it. No! No, man! Look at that! That's a sub-NHL goal. I'll just say it. And that's also a sub-NHL goaltender. I know that because he's the Leafs' third goaltender! Except he's not. He's mystifyingly the second goaltender now, and the first goaltender's hurt, so that makes him the first goaltender. Well, what happened to the $3.5 million guy? I don't know, he just forgot. He just forgot how to stop pucks, which is his job. Is he hurt? I don't know. Like, dude, I don't want to lean on the crutch of blaming Martin Jones for things because he's the third goalie. He makes less than $1 million. He should not be the starter. He should be the starter in a doomsday scenario. And I didn't think at the beginning of the season, the doomsday scenario would be the rookie goalie gets hurt and the starting goalie who you just gave $3.5 million to simply forgets. He forgot how to stop pucks. Oh, does that mean he's bad all of the time? It'd be easier if Samsonov was bad all of the time. He is intermittently good, which means you gotta play him sometimes. And the Leafs weren't able to score because, gosh darn it, you can't win every game by pulling your goalie questions. Do serious questions have to be asked about coaching staff? Because it's been all these years and Leafs are still unwilling to show up and put effort in games against weaker teams, even if they are our provincial rivals. Yeah, man, like, you do, but Sheldon Keefe's been the head coach this entire time. How many guys have come and gone in this organization, though? Greg Cronin was there. Tim Hunter was there. Babcock was there. Steve Spott was there. DJ Smith was there. Spencer Carberry was there. Paul McLean was there. He was just watching from afar. I know they've gone through a few goalie coaches and video coaches. You might say to yourself, yeah, Steve, I mean, Sheldon Keefe is the obvious common denominator here. He's been the head coach for a long time. You might have a point. You do have a point. The personnel. The core. Dude. If you have to tell a dog how to be a dog, maybe it's just a cat. How do you make them want it as much as the fan base does? Are you confident when the Leafs win the Stanley Cup, Toronto will be there the next morning? Like, are you sure? Are you sure? Like, this city might actually just bury itself in a bed of volcanic ash, like Pompeii. You have John Tavares standing there, frozen in time, like, and future, like, historians and archaeologists and paleontologists will this fan base will lose its actual mind! And they're out there like this. They're back-checking on guys who, like, are probably gonna get, like, voted on for the Hall of Fame one day. Like they're playing shuffleboard. Sorry, but the stars who make the lion's share of the money are expected to give the lion's share of the effort. Produce the lion's share of results. That's not unfair. That is on the dotted line. That's what all of those guys signed up for the day they put ink to paper. You gotta produce every night. You don't like it? Rip up the contract, give the money back, and sign for less. Yeah, but there's a lot of paperwork involved. Tell you what, it might be easier to just try! This team still has first round exit written all over it, says Manhattan. Dude, no, it's still December. It's not even the halfway mark of the season. I am trying to be a man of peace and not think that way. But every time I look at the standings, it's the Leafs play in Boston or the Leafs play in Florida, and they are, well, we're not having those conversations yet. It's still deep in the regular season. We're not having them yet, but they're around the corner. I'll just say that. Why are we the way that we are, says producer Nick? Because Matt Sundin tied that game against Carolina and we all believed for a second and then they lost and we've never recovered. We've never really talked about that, processed that as a collective, and we really need to start.
A few hours later.
And now Jeff O'Neill's job is to talk about the Leafs, are you kidding me? Anyway, we've spent too much time on that. What's next? How was your Christmas? It was good. It was good. It was, stable, you know, and, less yelling than usual. It was good. There was yelling, but it was like a three-year-old going, Santa! Because it was great. Hung out with the Italians and had a lot of fish. This one from Frizz Bob is a conversation not everyone is going to be stoked about. Mitch Marner tonight, and it's a car, and it has the option to do a simple direct breakout pass or turn off a dipsy doodle pass attempt that is instantly intercepted. Now, to be fair, Max Domi did this a lot in this game, but also to be fair, Mitch Marner makes nearly four times what Max Domi does, so I don't care nearly as much about Max! Man, it's amazing, because he's still putting up points, and he's been scoring goals recently. Like, the bar for, like, Mitch seems impossible, and Austin as well, and Willie as well, and John as well, and can't bring myself to feel bad. That's what the money's for. He has not played his best hockey. You could argue he played his best hockey last year. He was nominated for the Selke Trophy. He was really good. Scored a lot of goals. Great defensive forward. Boy, does he sort of just look like he's a guy out there on some nights. This was Where's Mitch Knight? This is, you see him and you're like, oh, let's go, Mitch. Yeah, way to go, Mitch. Good hustle, Mitch. Oh, that's Callie Yarncroak. Do you know how many times I've done that? If you ever find yourself in that position and you're not sure who is who, the one skating with purpose is Yarncroak. He got an assist. Wasn't a banner night for Willie. He got an assist. Wasn't a banner night for Austin. Concerned about Mitch, man. And lastly, how do the Leafs play a great 20 minutes, then completely just stop playing with still 40 minutes to go? Difficult to answer, but I'll put it this way. Last year, there was a big debate around this game. This game, the first game after Christmas, because the Leafs got together for a flight that was like an hour or two before December 27th. By NHLPA rules, the Leafs were not allowed to fly out on December 26th. They did, not by a wide margin, it was late at night, but they did. And that caused the Leafs to be fined $100,000. And the Leafs paid the fine. Then what happened? Their game in St. Louis. It was ridiculous that they scheduled the Leafs to play in St. Louis if they're going to have that tight of a schedule. But the Leafs went to St. Louis and won. And so people talked about, you know what? Even though the Leafs broke the rules, the organization will not care about spending $100,000 to get 2 points in the standings, which is what the Leafs got. That is what the organization is willing to do to help the Leafs win. The equipment, the coaching staff, the video staff, the amenities, the food, the fame, the deals that come with it, the everything. And yeah, this fan base asks for a lot, but it's not too much to ask for a consistent 60-minute effort, and they so rarely get it. Why? You're gonna wish you gave that effort against a bottom-feeding team on home ice, because now you got a back-to-back with travel against Columbus and Carolina. Have fun with that, guys. Have fun. So my question to you for the comments section, was that game just a blip, just a Christmas hangover? They were tired, they were drowsy, they were whatever. Or is this part of a bigger problem? Is there something you would like to see changed? Goaltending seems pretty obvious. Would you go out and get someone, even though you know Wool is eventually going to come back? Would you do something to the defense, the offense, the coaching staff? What should be priority one for this team? Let me know. But for now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like. If you like this video, click subscribe. If you really liked it, tell all your friends. Subscribe to this channel, but also SDPN. There's a really fun video that went up yesterday. It's me talking to all the fans in Sweden. We had a Swede time where the Leafs gave, well, yeah, even those weren't perfect efforts, but they won and everyone was happy.